told you they would be here.
All right, what's your secret?
How did you know this time?
Dad, I'm not really getting anything. He's good. Checking his watch. Our senator's a busy man. They're walking in. I'm following them. I'm going in. This is my jam. It's a good one. They're going into the North Penthouse.
You gotta go down to 2206.
Would you like your room turned down? Shalou!
What accent is that?
I don't know, like a Scottish mixed with Selma Hayek.
We need to workshop that a little bit more.
The room is clear. Vertigo moment.
What do you mean? What are you doing?
Molly, what's going on? I can't see.
What's happening out there? Please, be careful.
I have a will. I need to leave my nothing to someone.
I will not plunge to my death.
Do not
plunge to your death.
Oh, my God.
Be very careful, please.
Dad, I've got it.
When you swear.
Well, well, darling. Here we are.
Molly, where are you?
Molly!
Get the pictures you need?
I'm not the one cheating.
No, you're the one taking the dirty pictures of it. You're the lowest of the low. You know that? You're beneath the paparazzi.
That hurts.
Just give me the camera. I said, give me the camera.
Okay.
Nice and slow. Atta girl. Now give it to me.
Catch!
No!
I am not a paparazzi!
Excuse me, can I talk to you for a second?
I'm not really the sugar daddy type, and I'm kind of busy here.
I understand. Excuse me. Sorry. I'm sorry to bother you. This woman right over here has been following you and taking your picture. I know she doesn't look it, but she's a private investigator that's been hired by her wife to prove that you've been cheating on the road. She doesn't have any real evidence yet, so if you pop on down to the next stop, I'm sure you can find a waitress that you can talk your way into her pants. Looks like you just freed up. Armin Ranford, FBI. Have you heard of the Georgian Mafia? A group of these monsters immigrated to the United States 15 years ago, led by a guy named Vor Koshlov. He deals in drugs, fraud, and extortion.
And what does this have to do with me?
We're leveling an indictment against Vor Koshlov this afternoon. His chief witness is a guy named Jason Patrone. Patrone did the books for Koshlov without knowing it. And we are in the process of convincing Jason Patrone to testify against Vor.
And I got a grilled cheese for lunch.
What?
What is your point?
My point is, Patrone's daughter goes to college in New Orleans, and we want you to keep an eye on her.
Don't you have somebody at the Bureau that can do that?
Our trainees would have a pretty difficult time passing as a college sorority girl. They're pretty beefy, and they got mustaches. And that's just the women. I did my homework on you. Your mother died when you were young. You were raised by your father, and by proxy, most of the Dallas police force. At 11, you became a really great shot, and you're well-versed in jiu-jitsu. I'm an Aikido man myself.
Sorry.
Why are you sorry?
Aikido is a fashionable way for fat housewives to lose weight at their local Equinox.
Are you calling me a fat housewife?
Yeah.
You don't think that jiu-jitsu is a dated form?
No, it's the most effective defense system there is when it comes to overcoming size.
Please.
I'm serious. With the right amount of leverage and speed, I could drive you through that window right now.
If you were behind the wheel of a forklift.
This is a waste of my time.
You know what a hard hit is?
Never heard of it.
It's an Eastern European enforcement practice. The family will plant someone into the life of the loved one of their enemy. The plant will work their way into the life of their target. Get close to them.
So the threat of a heart hit alone is enough to prevent testimony?
Exactly. There's a heart hit planted on Jason's daughter's life.
Her name is Alex Patrone.
We think that she's holding something for her father, some evidence against Koshlov.
Financial statements, accounting ledgers that provide her dad with a bargaining chip of some sort.
I can't do it. I'm needed here.
$15,000.
I've got a kid.
No, you don't. You got a dad who got kicked off the police force who loves to gamble.
Same thing.
I'm offering you a chance to do something real here. A chance to work for the FBI. A chance to possibly make a real difference in someone's life. Think about it, Molly. Because we both know that chasing cheating truckers is not the top rung of investigative fulfillment. My card. In case you change your mind.
Not going to. Where were you?
Oh, I had dinner with the guys.
That coffee cup you're holding is from Rolly Roasters, and there's only two franchises in the Dallas area, the airport and Lone Star Park. You always read the newspaper at dinner with the guys, yet that newspaper you're holding hasn't been opened yet, and the red stamp on your hand gives you access to the box seat section. So tell me, Dad. How was the track?
You're too quick for me, Mo.
How much?
Look, I was so close to getting that money for that lawyer. I was so close to getting back on the fourth, and then I was just one hot streak away.
Dad.
Then I lost. Then I chased.
How much?
$17,000.
Thank you.
What is this place?
You'll see. We gained you entry to Alex's sorority. You're a transfer from University of Hawaii.
Obscure school, far away, smart. But I need more money.
What?
Listen, I'm gonna take the gig. I'm gonna go to the college, I'll even throw on some lipstick, but I'm gonna need $5,000 more.
Fine, but you're gonna do a hell of a lot more than just put on lipstick.
Okay, you're like 40 minutes late.
Who's this?
I'm busy.
You're busy?
No, Molly, her name is Busy. She works out of the New York office.
So what's this look we're rocking? Hobo chic?
I don't get it.
Okay, you have to, like, try on all these clothes.
Fine.
No, Molly. You say totally, or you say its shorter cousin, totes, when you want to say fine.
Okay, then. Let's go.
Accessories. Marc Jacobs Aussie Tote in fuchsia.
The essentials.
Maybelline Shine Sensational Lip Gloss in Cherry Kiss and Crushed Candy. MAC Luster Lipstick in Quiet Please. Molly, this is Zingati. He's the bomb.com when it comes to hair. Extra sugar-free dessert delights in mint chocolate chip and strawberry shortcake. Double bubble, bubble gum. Gum. 2 packs.
They blindfolded me when they drove me here.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was totes inappropriate.
No, I liked it. It's kind of like my last Craigslist experience.
Amazeballs.
What balls?
This is the Kappa Kappa Zeta pecking order. You're gonna need to know this to fit into the house. At the top, we got Sasha Stolzinski. She is ruthless and power hungry and runs the house with an iron fist-ish. She's like Gaddafi with highlights.
In styler rolling hot iron, trust me, you'll need it.
If binging and purging were a crime, she'd be on death row. Do you know what I'm saying?
Not really. I cut my hair myself.
In an earthquake?
These are her top three lieutenants, Cotton, Taylor, and Hunter.
Cotton, Taylor, Hunter.
They were conceived while their parents were having sex at an L.L. Bean outlet store. This is your target right here, Alex Patrone. You are her best friend.
Got it.
Bravo Wicked Thin Lubricated Condoms, size large, jumbo pack.
Yeah, I won't be needing those.
It's like a sad animal attempted suicide on her head.
You both know I'm sitting right here.
If anyone can do it, you can. You're the hair whisperer.
This is your phone.
What'd you do, rob a 9-year-old?
No, you're actually gonna use this phone, okay? It's got a built-in Kappa app with information on all your sorority sisters.
Kappa app?
That's right, okay? And this one you will not use, but keep it on you and on at all times.
Why?
Because that's how I'm gonna find you. You'll receive a text.
What if I need to call you?
You'll get a text.
So if I need to call you, I'm gonna get a text?
Correct.
Makes no sense. Kappa phone, bat phone.
Don't call it a bat phone.
Why not?
It belittles the importance of the phone.
Okay. I'm sorry, but I'm calling it a bat phone.
No, look, the bat phone was red, and it was a landline, and Bruce Wayne used it for calls, and you're only using that to receive texts, so it just, I don't see the point. Okay?
Okay. Bat phone.
This, right here, is your brand new Volkswagen Eos.
Come on, can't I ride my bike to school?
Girls your age would jump up and down at the chance to drive this thing.
Well, I'm not like most girls.
Brooke Stonebridge is.
Who's Brooke Stonebridge?
It's your new identity.
Are you serious? That's not a name. That's a gated community.
I really don't care.
Holy shit.
Oh my God.
Holy shit.
Oh my God. Try it.
Try what?
You say, oh my God, when you want to say, holy shit.
Oh my God?
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God!
It's a fashion miracle.
Oh my God. I'm like a brand new chick.
singing.
Brooke Stonebridge. Hi, I'm Brooke Stonebridge. Nice to meet you.
Canceling.
Cameron, it's Kappa. Welcome back, Matt. I have to be there.
You're choosing your sorority sisters over my father? Cotton, listen to me. I'm late as it is. I still have to shave my chest and meditate before I meet my parents, so just meet us at the horse show.
Cameron, I told you I can't.
Cotton, sometimes you can be such an insipid idiot.
Cameron, I don't know what that word means.
What kind of idiot doesn't know what the word idiot means?
No, the other one.
Insipid. Devoid of character.
I have character, Cameron. Last year for Halloween, I was a raspberry.
Just shut up.
Easy there.
You have a problem?
I just think you could be a bit more patient.
Oh, really? Don't be late.
Hope that wasn't a first date. I'm Brooke.
I don't care who you are. That is Cameron Harrison. He's the president of Omega Alpha Pi and the son of Senator Harrison.
Sorry, I was just
You are so insipid. Who the hell are you?
I'm really gonna love it here. I'm just a transfer.
Oh.
Another pledge!
Oh, when you pledge!
Hello, beautiful, vibrant Kappa sister.
Hey, I'm Brooke. What?
You're supposed to greet me back.
I did.
No, the way that I greeted you.
Right, of course. Hello, beautiful, vibrant Kappa sister.
Those are the words that I use. You have to use your own words.
Hello, sweet, freshly manicured, evenly spray tan Kappa sister.
Hi, I'm Sasha, president of Kappa Kappa Zeta, and you're Brooke Stonebridge, our transfer from Hawaii.
And you're really well informed.
Well, now that you've seen the chapter in which you know boys are never allowed in.
I wasn't planning on it.
Just saying. Let me show you upstairs. Come on.
You know, you seem more mature than the other girls.
Well, that's because I'm older. I was modeling in Croatia for 3 years before I came here.
Croatia?
Yeah. People always think of Milan when they think of high fashion, but Croatia is the new golden age of couture. It's Paris in 1947.
Is it? Oh my God, under the stars of the blue southern sky where girls become women, we bake apple pie. There's fish and there's trees, there's tents and there's cheese.
Waka waka hey, waka waka who, waka waka me, waka waka you.
You went to Camp Waka Waka?
You don't remember me?
I'm sorry, I don't.
Brooke, Stonebridge, I was in Cabin Whisper 9. Kinda was a loner. Ate a lot of bugs.
Oh, okay. Can you believe what happened to Shelly Simon?
I know, isn't it fantastic?
She lost her arm.
What she's doing with the other arm. She's just so strong. You know, I was really nervous about transferring here, but I am so psyched that I already have a friend.
Right. I just love reunions.
Toast.
And this is your room. Your stuff's here already. Your roommate Becky is so great. You will so love her. She's so great. And she's real, which is so important because, well, there are just so many fake girls in this house.
How'd that sound?
I've been working that accent since last year.
I'm Becky Slotsky.
Brookstone Bridge.
Oh, my grandparents just moved there.
I didn't choose the name.
I see you've met Sasha. You know she's really like that, and that's unmedicated. Did she drop the modeling thing?
Oh, yeah. Croatia. It's Paris in 1947.
I know what you're thinking. My mother was a Kappa, which makes me a legacy and means that they have to let me in. So how'd you get into Kappa Brookstone Bridge?
The FBI arranged it.
You're funny.
Like it?
Is this a Triumph?
1972, story of myself.
Bonneville engine?
Yeah.
That's rad.
Nicholas.
Brooke.
Nice to meet you. You don't go to school here, do you?
Of course I do. Why would you think that I don't? I'm in my late teens, I'm walking on campus, I got a pretentious name and a sparkly cell phone.
I don't know, not many girls here would know this bike's a Triumph.
Really? Oh. Well, I just think it's amazeballs. We got little pills, ain't we pretty? See us on the walls in the big bright city. Don't you wanna be like us? Don't you wanna be like us? We got little pills, ain't we awesome? But she's super chic like apple pie wholesome. Don't you wanna be like us?
Oh my gosh. More than anything in the world? Okay, a big house in Winter Park. A tall husband who makes a lot of money, but is also properly God-fearing. And a pearl white Bentley Continental GT. With the pink Jesus fish on the back bumper.
Oh, nice.
Taylor, your turn.
Okay. I want to live in Beverly Hills and, like, be on TV, but not on one of those cheesy reality shows. No, I want to be on a really quality reality show so I can have a billion Twitter followers and go to Cabo with Chelsea Handler. Oh, and I def want a pearl white Bentley, too. Wait, what's your name again?
Brooke.
Your turn, Brooke.
What I want?
More than anything in the whole world.
More than anything. A Sigarm 1911 pistol with a hand-striped V-notch rear, a GSR stainless steel but with a black nitron finish, a seamless P226 slide, and Tritium night sights. And a pearl white Bentley.
Where's my Eyelicious moisturizer? Damn it! Somebody stole it.
Girl, welcome to the club. Somebody stole my neck massager. Wait, I think somebody stole my lip gloss. Sweetie, it's in your hand.
Oh.
A lot nicer than the Camp Waka Waka bathrooms.
I like that.
Oh, it was a gift.
It's really pretty. Why is this so important to all of them?
Well, because this is their world. It used to be mine. I'm sorry, I'm being totally cynical. I'm sure you'll love all of the pageantry. But the real world comes and gets us all at some point, you know?
Oh my God. I'm so sorry, Alex.
What did you do? My shirt is ruined. This was my special Kappa Kappa Zeta t-shirt. And you ruined it. Like, OMG, I'm messing with you.
Are you making fun of me?
I am.
Okay, let's see if we're up and running. I'm so undercover.
Welcome back and welcome home. It was a summer of change, a summer of big developments, and a summer of making new friends. We have a year of great excitement ahead of us, including winning the Lafitte Cup back from those easy alpha girls. Yeah. But to do that, we need to sell more dolls than any of the other houses. Kappas, are you up for that? Yeah! Okay, let the festivities begin.
It only takes a spark to get a fire going, and soon our sister's hell will warm up in its glowing. That's how it is with
watch out!
Godless OAP boys.
Huh?
They're always trying to catch us exercising topless or something.
They totally caught me once. I was so mad.
Look, pretty little fire.
Okay.
You may as well have turned to this date on my calendar and painted it black.
Wow, that was disturbingly poetic. Look, I really am sorry. It was just an accident.
No, an accident is like when you're driving and you hit a raccoon, but you don't want to stop because it turned out to be somebody's dog. This is a tragedy. All right, girls, let's go.
Racketeer Influenced and Corrupt Organizations Act, RICO, allowed law enforcement to get into areas it had never been before when it came to investigating the mafia.
It was the Nixon hustle.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry, but you're not telling the whole story.
Well, enlighten us.
The Justice Department used RICO to go after anybody on Nixon's hate list. Gays, liberals, reformers, subversive students. Yeah, RICO was enacted to go after the mob, but don't tell me that it wasn't abused.
I won't. What's your name?
Brooke.
How would someone like you know this, Brooke?
I don't know. I guess I'm just, like, so into crime, I want to throw up.
Interesting take on RICO.
I don't really know what I'm talking about.
Hey, Summer! That was kind of rude. She was my freshman roommate last year. I haven't seen her since then.
She's probably just trying to keep it low.
Keep what low?
Her affair with a good doctor.
What are you talking about?
She's probably in one of his lectures, and now they're on their way to go have some scandalous motel room sex.
Come on, how do you know that, Brooke?
The parking pass on the back of his car is preferential for doctors. He's not wearing a wedding ring, but I could see the tan line, and she obviously knows he's married, so that's not why he doesn't wear it. It's just a guilt thing that cheating men do.
Wow. All I saw was Summer and some guy. I'm impressed. You got a really nice sense of deduction, Brooke.
I developed it early.
What?
I don't know. I should probably not talk anymore. Okay, amazeballs. I'm gonna go nap now.
Shit.
What's up?
Finance major. Why can't I be like everyone else in the house and just marry one?
What are those books?
Not books, ledgers. Big, fat accounting ledgers.
You know they have computers for that, right?
Our sadist teacher makes us do it all by hand. That way we really learn. Ugh, I need a break. See ya.
How's it going?
I'm retaining water and I'm not sure why.
Wait, why are you in a room?
I'm just borrowing Alex's, thong. You know how we like to all borrow each other's stuff.
I guess so.
Brandy.
Huh?
If you drink brandy, you won't retain all that water.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thanks, Brooke.
No prob.
See ya. I'll try that. Armin, you made me ride the whole streetcar line.
Precautions. Follow me. All right, update me.
There's nothing to say. Look, I know I haven't been there that long, but I know dangerous people, and there's none in that house.
Take a look at this.
Oh, my God. That's busy.
Yep. Kashlov had her killed.
I don't get it. Why wouldn't they just kill Alex? Why would they go to all the trouble planting someone in her life?
If he has Alex killed, then her father will definitely testify. The only way he can gain momentum right now is by planting a killer in wait. You have to take this seriously. Find out who's not who they say they are and try to uncover any information about this bargaining chip that Alex may be holding.
Party.
What?
It's a tradition. We wake each other up in the middle of the night, then go to a frat party without showering or changing. So basically, everyone's showering and changing right now to make it look like they didn't shower or change.
You sleep with a gun?
It's not real.
It's not?
Of course not.
Your money or your laugh. I'm gonna bust a cat in your ass.
Give it back.
It's a cap.
What's a cap?
It's bust a cap in your ass.
How would anybody put a cap in their ass?
Because, Cotton, that's what the gangsters do.
That's weird.
Oh, and putting a cat in your ass isn't weird at all. You're a real Einstein, Cotton.
I am not.
I can't believe you would wear that here. You look like a cheap tramp.
Cameron, you bought this for me for my birthday.
No, I didn't. My father's secretary did, and I just signed the card. And don't you think for a second that she's not going to get fired for making you look like a New Jersey housewife.
I guess he's better once you get to know him.
Not really. He just called me a housewife.
Cotton, you don't need to take that.
Wait, did he just propose to me?
I don't think so.
Do you think I'm pretty?
Oh my god. Sometimes I want to kill you because you are so pretty. I'm serious. I think about killing you a lot.
You're so sweet.
Hey, can I interest you in a dip in the white trash pool over there?
Already been. Got a disease now, by the way.
Hey, happens to the best of us. I mean, if you want to go take your mind off of it.
Can you not do that?
There's this amazing old school jazz band you got to let me take you to see. Oh. It's in the French Quarter, and it's not a place students usually go, but I promise you'll have a lot of fun.
Not really here to have fun. Besides, I hate the French.
That's it for today. I appreciate the majority of you taking this unit seriously. Remember, your papers are due next week. Make them great.
Say what do we have?
Professor Nathan Tolloway. He's been teaching for about a year and a half, but the guy has nothing on his background. He's a complete ghost.
She's sleeping with him?
Possibly. Sasha's not telling the truth about her past either.
How do you know that?
She claims that she modeled in Croatia for 3 years, which is smarter than saying Paris, because it's a memorable detail that will help settle a lie. It's called a unique qualifier. I use them all the time. When she told me, she leaned her head back, looked to the right, and whined her eyes and touched her lip. These are all nonverbal tales of deception found in women's.
What about guys? Is she dating anyone?
There's this guy, Nicholas Dexter, in our criminal justice class, but I don't think there's anything romantic between them.
What about him?
Oh, he's smart, and he's got this boyish charm about him, but he's not as immature as the other frat boys.
Jesus. God bless you.
What?
You're into him.
I'm not. And BT Dubs, if anything, he's the one crushing on me.
BT Dubs?
By the way.
Crushing on you? What does that mean?
He kind of asked me out.
You gonna go out with him?
I told him that I hate the French. No, I'm not here to date.
Obviously, but you are here to investigate anyone that comes into her life, okay? I'm gonna get some intel on the professor. You investigate Sasha and go out with Nicholas.
I don't think going out with Nicholas is the best way to go about this.
Of course it is. What else?
Well, I'm writing this totally kick-ass paper about the pros and cons of Rico.
What does that have to do with Alex?
Nothing, I guess.
Yeah, man, she's crazy. I don't even know what. What's up? How's your head?
Yeah, I know. No,
see you later.
No doubt.
Brooke. Hey, Brooke.
Nicholas. Hey.
How you doing? You mean, enjoyed the party last night?
Yeah, just been, you know, so busy with school.
Yeah.
Wish I could just burn off some steam, go to some old jazz club or something, you know, just let loose.
Well, there's that place I told you about in French Quarter,
but it's swarming with lazy French people.
Maybe they deserve a second chance.
Yeah, tell that to Algeria.
I don't know what that means, but I bet it was really funny.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe I'll do that.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd love to tag along.
Your balls are amazing.
For my balls?
I meant to say that would be amaze balls.
Right.
I think I gotta go.
You okay, Brooke?
Yeah, me? I'm great. I'm the bomb.com.
All right, well, I'll see you tonight.
See ya.
If you're not from New Orleans, let me hear you scream.
Greatest music ever created, and nobody cares.
You from here?
Listen to that. That is all about call and response.
You're not into this, are you?
No, I am. I am. I just want to get to know you a little bit more. That's all.
Well, you're the bigger mystery than me.
Me?
Yeah, I mean, you come out of nowhere, you know, about motorcycles and Rico statutes, and suddenly you're this little Kappa girl who's thebomb.com and just wants to throw up.
Where are you from?
That is harmony and interpretation.
Why won't you answer me?
I'm just into this.
Are you hiding something?
No. No, you can ask me anything.
Have you ever killed somebody? Huh? I'm kidding.
You got a strange sense of humor, Brooke.
Yeah, love it or leave it. So?
I'm from Florida.
He kept on asking me about a job this, a job that, and I told him I didn't want to get a job. I was trying really hard in school, and I was on the baseball team, and I didn't have time for a job. He just looked at me and told me he was leaving, that he met a woman, that he didn't love my mother anymore, and that I was going to have to take care of her and my sister. And he told me it just like that, like he was telling me what to pick up from the store. And that's why I quit playing baseball in high school. I'm sorry, I didn't plan on telling you that story.
It's okay.
Well, we're at your house again.
One more time around the block?
I've walked you home 6 times tonight.
Let's make it 7.
It's
So what about you? Are your parents together?
No, my mom died when I was younger.
Did your dad remarry?
No.
What's he do?
I don't really want to get into it right now, Nicholas. Don't be mad at me.
I'm not mad. I don't know. I've been opening up to you all night, and you basically deflect any real question I ask you about yourself.
I just don't trust people that easy. I don't have the most faith in relationships, that's all.
Why not?
Because I've been there. I've seen it. People lie, and they misrepresent themselves, and they let each other down.
Well, I don't lie. I don't misrepresent myself, and as far as I know, I don't let anyone down.
You better be who you say you are. Because I'll know if you're not. Pull it together, Morris.
Oh my God, look, the Lafitte dolls came in. Look, aren't they adorable? These guys.
I had this terrible dream that Taylor was in our room.
Oh, it really is you.
We have to sell at least 100 at the event tomorrow. Okay, Owen, Brooke. Thank you so much for the tip. I've been drinking like a ton of brandy and I've been feeling a lot better. And I'm actually fitting into my Can't Breathe jeans again. It's like that amazing time I had the stomach flu. Anyways, you're the best. I'll talk to you later.
Sleep in.
Like I care.
Okay, team. How are we gonna get people dying to buy these dolls?
I know. We can give away a can of my homemade mace as a prize.
No.
We can think of something better.
Come on, girl. Let's sell some crawdaddies.
Cotton. You make your own mace?
Yeah. I'm a chemistry major.
You're a chemistry major?
Yes, Brooke. I'm gonna become a perfumer like Anik Kutal.
Oh.
They're just upset because my last prototype burned some holes through leather purses, but I perfected it now. Here. This one's for you. See, there's a place for your keys on it, and there's a little flashlight.
Thank you, Cotton.
Use it wisely. Wait, at least I think that's the one I perfected.
Buy a crawdaddy.
Buy a doll, play with balls.
Buy a doll, play with balls.
Didn't Lady Gaga wear that at the VMAs?
Brooke?
No.
I recognize your voice.
Well, aren't you just the great detective?
Okay, so let me get this straight. Your fighting crawdad who's encouraging people to buy a doll so that they can play inside of a giant inflatable child's toy that's more of a liability nightmare than anything else.
Bingo.
Not happening. The only thing you will be kissing is my ass. I'm done. I'm done. Screw the dolls. I'm done.
Have you sold many dolls?
Believe it or not, no. Where's everybody going?
The Alpha Lambda Alpha Car Wash.
Alpha Car Wash?
Prostitution with detergent, if you ask me.
They're so lucky they had bad childhoods.
There's no way we're gonna sell all of our dolls in 2 days with all of our clothes on.
We have to come up with something.
We're going to win the Lafitte Cup, I promise you.
How?
Just trust me.
That guy looks so much like Cameron.
Come on, don't let me down. There we are. Dr. Milton?
Yes. Have we met?
No, but I can promise you, you're gonna want to be my friend.
Really?
Really. Mm-hmm. The waterbed one's my favorite. Really brings out your smile. Would be a great Christmas card, don't you think?
What do you want?
Here you go, Dr. Milton.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Happy to help. You know how important this is to me.
The negatives are in the box.
Are we done?
Yep. See ya.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Brooke, how'd you do it?
Oh, I just, you know, had to convince him that all the sick kids in his ward deserve to love our daddies like everybody else.
That's so Christian of him. Talk about a man with a big heart.
Yep, and he shares it with everybody.
Oh my God, I can't believe you sold all our dolls!
I know we've gotten off to a rocky start, but I want to smooth things over. Come here. Sister dysfunction is just so toxic, you know?
Yeah.
Taylor says you helped her with her water problem. And Cotton says you've been defending her when Cameron gets out of hand. And well, if it wasn't for you, we never would have sold all those dolls, and everybody Avi loves you.
My bracelet. I would be honored if you were to wear it.
Cool. Thanks.
No, really, Brooke, where I come from, this is a really big deal. But this is a bracelet with the words Mother Green Earth surrounded by real crusted pink moissanite.
Wow. Thanks, Sasha. I love it.
Are you gonna put it on?
Duh.
OMFG, so cute.
Well, you threw the F in there, so it must be super cute.
Hi, Brooke.
Morning.
Good morning, Brooke.
Hey, come meet with us.
I'll save you a seat, okay?
Okay, cool.
Where did you get that?
Get what?
The bracelet.
Oh, Sasha gave it to me.
That's my bracelet. That was my mother's bracelet before. Her name is right there on it.
This is Green Earth. Your mom's name was Green Earth?
Yeah.
Was she a hippie?
No, Brooke, she was 100% Welcome Sioux and Indian. Do you have a problem with that?
No, it's just, you know, you don't really look Indian.
I was adopted, do you have a problem with that?
No, it's just, Sasha gave it to
me. Sasha, can you come here for a minute, please? Did you give Brooke this bracelet?
No, I don't think so.
What?
That's your mother's name, isn't it?
Okay, I see what's going on here.
Oh my God, Brooke. I think we found our kleptomaniac.
That's my iPod.
That's my eyelicious moisturizer. My neck massager.
There's gonna be a hearing on this, Brooke. You may be out of the house.
You have no idea who you're messing with.
I guess Cameron was right about you, Brooke. You're no sister of mine.
Sasha set me up.
With you?
I didn't steal anything, Cotton.
I don't believe you.
How's it going? Something good, please.
I'm sorry, honey, but I checked everything. I checked the tenant system. I checked the Texas DMV backlogs. I checked six other record and notification databases. There's nothing for a Sasha Stolzinski.
All right, it's fine. I'll figure it out. How are you?
I'm going to a meeting.
Good. I love you.
I love you, too.
They don't hate you.
Yes, they do. They think I'm a klepto. What are you doing?
I'm making sure I still have my wallet.
Stop. I'm serious. You know, they were just starting to accept me, and now I've become the enemy, which, trust me, it doesn't help anything.
Well, you're a girl. Didn't you deal with this stuff growing up?
Well, I worked a lot.
What kind of work did you do?
Photography.
Well, I like weddings.
No, more, nature photography. Mostly dogs.
They don't hate you, Brooke. Okay, nobody can hate you.
Thanks.
I'm really happy to hear.
So am I. You're amazing.
What's actually, my balls are amazing.
That doesn't even make sense.
You're the one that said it.
I have to go. Now I have to go.
Not yet.
You. I was hoping you were a kidnapper.
Nope, just me. Everybody's least favorite Kappa sister.
You know they already have a nickname for you. I won't tell you if you don't want to hear it.
Thanks.
Fingers. Fingers Stonebridge.
Well, that's an improvement over Brooke, don't you think? Becky, I'm not a klepto.
What's that?
Something I stole from Sasha's room. Oh my God. Becky, you've got to see this.
That's Sasha.
Yeah, but it's not her real name. There are just so many fake girls in this house. I just hate fake people, don't you, Sasha?
What do you want?
Your name's Susie Walters, not Sasha Stolzinski. You never modeled in Croatia. You've never even been to Croatia. You were working at a Taco Bell when you got your scholarship here, and you're 40 pounds heavier.
Why do you have a gun, Brooke?
Because I'm here looking for someone who's not who they say they are, and, well, I found you. Why the lies, Susie?
Are you gonna shoot me?
I doubt it. Why the lies?
Because when I got into college, I had the chance to start all over. All my life, I've been on the outside. Sweet 16s and proms and boys. You don't know what it feels like to watch it all go by as you sit on the sidelines.
Actually, Susie, I do.
Who are you?
Your new best friend.
Commencing the Kappa Kappa Zeta disciplinary hearing.
We are all here today to hear Brooke Stonebridge's version of why she stole all our stuff. I don't know what that word means.
Just say it.
Allegedly. Brooke Stonebridge, what do you have to say for yourself?
Kleptomania is a disease. It's all about bulimia in this house, and I totally get that, but we shouldn't cast off the kleptomaniac because they also have a disease. Would we dump the diabetic? Abandon the epileptic? Come on, girls, we're supposed to be sisters. So with that said, I implore you all to forgive and open your hearts to a sister in need.
I stole all the stuff and planted it on Brooke.
I knew it. You better not have used it.
That's sad.
Hey, Brooke, listen, I'm so sorry that I hated you and spread all those nasty rumors.
What?
It is such a relief to let go of the lies. So happy you don't all hate me.
Well, you know, Brooke put it best. You can't hate the apocalyptic for having a seizure.
Cotton, it's epileptic.
I know. My dog had it once.
Alex. Alex, are you okay?
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Look, I know you're new and trying to make friends, but there are problems in the real world that are a lot bigger than asshole boyfriends or Lafitte dolls. These problems are very real and way bigger than anything that you need to solve in order to fit in.
Okay.
I have to go.
Professor Calloway.
The guy who killed Busy and he's talking.
That's great.
He led us to this.
No. No.
His name is Patrick Franklin.
I know liars. And Nicholas isn't one.
His name is Patrick and he outplayed you, Morris. Accept it. The guy did a deuce down in Sumter where he hooked up with a top Kashlov lieutenant. If he worked with Kashlov on the inside, then obviously he's working with him now on the outside.
This isn't right. No, what about the professor? What about what I told you?
Alex is obviously sleeping with him.
I want you to not let this guy out of your sight.
Okay, but I wasn't. Don't you just hate that? Doesn't it just suck when people aren't who or what they say they are?
Brooke, I'm not really following.
Actually, you know what? Oh my God, I am so drunk. I'm a drunk college girl, woohoo! You know what I like to do when I'm drunk? Sex it up. What do you say, you wanna sex it up?
Okay, Brooke, this is a little weird. You know, it's not that I'm not interested in going there with you. You know, I'm very interested, trust me. It's just the way it's currently being presented to me is a little, oh my.
You know, I'm super pumped to get with you this way, Nicholas. I don't even think we need a safe word.
See, this is deviant, you know? But don't you think it's best we work up to this?
I knew you were too good to be true, Patrick.
Who's Patrick? Oh,
very cute. What happened to I don't lie? I don't misrepresent myself, and as far as I know, I don't let anybody down.
Okay, now I think I might want that safe word.
I thought she was you!
Good boy. Professor Tolloway's FBI? If Professor Tolloway's FBI, then who's Armin? Calloway. You're gonna be okay.
Look.
It's Molly. You're FBI. What happened to you?
I'm shot.
Hello? We need to get an ambulance here to 602 Lanterna Road. An ambulance is on its way.
You're not with Kashlov, are you?
No, not intentionally. They hired me. They claim to be FBI. I'm just a PI from Dallas. Where's Alex?
They took her.
Why? Why did they take Alex?
Ledgers.
What ledgers?
Accounting. Accounting ledgers. Jason had kept Kashlov's books.
A bargaining chip.
But she wouldn't tell anyone where they were. Not even me.
A bargaining chip. That's what Armin wants. The ledgers. The killer could be anybody.
Molly?
Somebody who's not who they say they are.
What are you doing?
Somebody who gets close to Alex.
You're only making this thing worse.
Me? I was the killer the whole time.
Bravo. You pack a mean punch.
Yeah, now I know why you didn't kill me. It's because you needed me to take the fall for you.
Smart. See, you actually did learn something in college.
Who's busy?
It doesn't matter now, does it?
You killed her.
I did not kill her. We had to cover our tracks on this thing, okay? I didn't kill her.
Give me Alex and I give you the ledgers. You heard me. I found them.
I'll give you $50,000 for
them. No. You brought me here to protect Alex Patrone, and that's exactly what
I'm doing. Oh, come on. What are you doing? You're gonna protect some sorority bitch?
You know, you really got me with that do something real, make a difference, join the FBI bullshit.
I had to say something.
Answer the phone when it rings, and if you have me followed, the letters go to the real FBI. Got it?
Yeah.
Oh, and that sorority bitch is my Kappa sister.
What time did Brooke leave the house?
I do not know. I am not my sister's keeper. What time do you anticipate her return?
Molly Morris? FBI.
Molly Morris?
Agent Sanderson is very weak, but he did let us know you've been helpful.
We checked, and there's nobody in the Kashlov family named Armin Ranford.
Then obviously he used a fake name with me.
We'll figure all of that out eventually. It's what we do. So thank you for your help, Molly. But we're gonna take over from here.
No. No, I started the job and I'm gonna finish it.
Miss Morris, with all due respect, we're the FBI and you're a young PI who specializes in infidelity photography.
Miss Keller, do you have Alex Patrone? And with all due respect, do you have the ledgers? No. He brought me here to find out who the FBI mole was, to lead him to the ledgers, and then for me to take the fall. He thinks he got 2 out of 3. He thinks he killed Agent Sanderson, and I'm gonna take the blame for it. But he doesn't have the ledgers. Nobody does.
Do you?
No, but I know where they are. He's waiting for me to call him. I can deliver him to you, but he's smart. He's gonna throw us a curve, and we need to anticipate that.
Why don't you let us worry about that?
I'm telling you, if there's one thing my experience has taught me, it's always have a contingency.
Brooke, what is going on?
What's platinum rule number 1 in the Kappa chapter book?
Never wear sweatpants.
Rule number 2.
A sister in need comes before anything else.
Girls, we have a sister in need.
Molly, the second he grabs the ledgers, you need to get on the ground, quickly.
My roommate's freaking out about getting these back. They're due tomorrow.
Look, it doesn't even matter that these aren't the real ledgers.
I know. Once he has them in hand, we can get him for obstruction of justice.
Exactly. From there, we can deal with him to give up Alex.
Agent Keller?
We're gonna come in fast and hard. Found this on a pile of Talloway's gravy papers. Don't tell anybody. But I couldn't agree with you more. Rico was a complete Nixon hustle.
Be ready, people.
Where's Alex?
Alex who?
What are you doing? Here.
I don't want those.
What are you doing?
Excuse me, I actually have to take this call.
Ow!
That was a low portal frequency jammer. I used to be a Fed. Can you imagine that?
Where'd they go? Somebody give me a location on Armin.
Alpha 1, do you have Molly? Alpha 2.
Now that I think about it, they actually did teach us how to detect lies.
Yeah, and obviously how to tell them.
Totes. I have to give it to you, Morris. You know how to play the game. What are these?
The ledgers.
Kashloff never dealt to widgets. Where are the real ledgers?
I don't know. That's all I have.
Where are the real ledgers?
I don't know. That's all I have.
Nada, come on. I'll take care of both of you at the same time.
Hey, Brooke. Hey, I found those journal thingies you were looking for.
Cotton, not now.
Of course not now. Like 8 minutes ago, silly. Who's this?
Brooke's dad.
Hi.
Yeah. Princess, why don't you introduce me to your friend here?
This is Cotton.
You came all the way from Hawaii?
Of course I did. I'd go anywhere for my little girl here. Mm. Yeah. So where are the journal thingies you were talking about?
Are you okay, Brooke? You're looking at me all weird, like I'm being insipid or something.
Where are the journal thingies that you were talking about, Cinnamon?
It's Cotton.
It doesn't matter.
They're in the chapter room.
Thank you so much. Nice meeting you.
You too.
Don't worry about her. She's a little sedated. I need you to take me to the chapter room. See what kind of skills you got. Come on.
Hey, Molly. It's all going according to plan. You're doing great. Alex is gonna be fine. Just stay calm.
The car is rigged. Anyone tries to get to Alex, I hit the trigger on this phone and the car explodes.
There's a bomb under the car. The keys are in his jacket pocket. Go now.
Excuse me.
Brooke, we need to talk.
Oh, no.
Who the hell is this?
Who the hell is this?
A guy I'm dating.
You're dating this guy?
Wait a minute, you're dating someone?
No, not this guy. Really?
What the hell is going on?
Wait a minute, is he a student?
I can't talk about this right now.
Why not?
When do you have time to date someone?
Where is the chapel room, Molly?
Who the hell is Molly? Hold on a second. You handcuff me to a radiator, you bust me in the head, and then you steal my bike? What the hell is that?
It was something personal.
What's it personal? You think me on. You tricked me into liking you, and then you beat me down.
That's not a good... You like me?
When this is all over, I would like a proper introduction.
Where the hell is the chapter room?
It's right there!
Come on. Where are the ledgers? Huh? What is that?
Mate!
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. No, Nicholas!
No, Nicholas!
Hey, what's your problem, man?
What you got, bonus Jonas? Bring it. Bravo. But you know, all I have to do is press 9 on this thing, and that car blows up.
You're lying.
Am I? Because you and I both know how easy it is to make a cocktail out of nitrocellulose and ketone. Slide it under the back seat. You recognize this phone, don't you? It's outfitted with a discontinued 6300 vibrator that can send a signal. Give me the gun. Give me the gun! You still want to see if I'm bluffing or not, don't you?
No.
Here we go.
No!
I don't think so.
Who's that?
I'm the contingency.
Oh, I think I gotta sit down.
Oh. Oh. You're in big trouble, Armin. There's no boys allowed in the chapter room.
Oh, everything's so
pink.
I like
Alex.
It, though.
Hey, Molly. Oh, my God. How did you...
Well, Sasha.
It's a disease. Good stuff, though.
How'd I do?
You did great, Cotton.
Put me in, Coach. No more of that stinking root beer. Drop and give me 20, God. Drop and give me 20.
The FBI's gonna be here soon. Why don't you guys go watch him?
Oh,
I need the ledgers now, Alex.
I'm gonna explode.
Yeah.
I want to go to Candy Mountain and float on the tears of unicorns.
That's real.
I got them. I got the kill shot from here, but I don't know if I can break!
Maybe I put too much Basidio in my coat of fungus in the mace.
Oh, it's glorious.
Wait, it's maybe glorious. I wasn't supposed to put any Basidio in my coat of fungus in the mace.
You can turn that car into a jungle gym if you want, girls. Knock yourself out!
I miss you.
I am so proud of you.
I'm proud of you, too.
Well, I'm your father, so let me be proud first.
Good work, Morris. The FBI could use someone like you.
Thank you, but I think I'm gonna stick around here and go to college. But, you know, my dad could use some help getting back on the force.
Molly.
What?
We'll see what we can do.
Make it happen. The ledgers.
The ledgers? Consider it done, Morris. Welcome back.
Thank you.
You're gonna be a cop again.
Brooke?
Dad, this is Nicholas.
Hi, nice to meet you, sir.
Who hit you?
Your daughter.
Yeah, she did.
Yeah, I'm just gonna leave you guys to, you know, get to know each other.
Hey, Brooke!
It's Molly.
I mean Molly. Come over here. Wait, her name's Molly?
I'm a cop, Nicholas. Just something to think about.
Hey. I'm so proud of you guys.
OMG, we are so badass.
I'm really happy you're my sorority sister.
Me too.
I hear some of those Easy Alpha girls have infiltrated the sorority council.
How do we know who they are?
We'll go undercover.
Wait, are we in the FBI now? Do we get a gun? Can I have a pink gun?
Why did you do that?
What you doing, Sherlock?
Cotton's dating this new guy, so I told her I'd check him out for her.
Ah, yes. Nature photography. So what's up with this guy?
So far, so good. He's getting his PhD in quantum physics, so, you know, they'll definitely be on the same page intellectually.
Well, that's cool for you to do that for her. Because, you know, people often aren't who they say they are. You know, they lie, Molly. They let each other down.
How long are you gonna do this for?
A couple years. Maybe 10.
10 years?
Well, you're the detective. Why don't you figure it out?
This is getting in the way.
I'm in a keto man.
A keto is a fashionable way for fat housewives to lose weight at their local Equinox.
Are you calling me a fat housewife?
Yep.
Look, I'm a fat housewife in an Equinox.
Yes.
Really?
Let's make a movie. Quietly. I'm not like most girls.
Well, Brooke Stonebridge is.
Who's Brooke Stonebridge?
Sir, is that all?
Yeah. I'm sorry, but these are so spicy.
That's an entrance.
I'll find out if you're not. I'll find out if you're not.
Still rolling and ready.
What am I doing for real?
Just like, don't jump.
Dude, I'm like, wait. Now what do you want me to do? Okay. Jump off the side? Me. What are we doing?
Jiu-jitsu. You're well versed in jiu-jitsu. You heard of the jiu-jitsu. That ends up anywhere, I'm gonna kill you.
I'm like totally undercover. I'm like so undercover. I'm so undercover.